and mother made this record in 1934. He was mother's accompanist. This is the best thing to wear for today. You understand? Because I don't like women in skirts. And the best thing is to wear pantyhose or some pants under a short skirt, I think. Then you have the pants under the skirt. And then you can pull the stockings up over the pants underneath the skirt. And you can always take off the skirt and use it as a cape. So I think this is the best costume for today. I have to think these things up, you know. The Libra husband is not an easy man to please. All I have to do is find this Libra man. All I need is audit law, you know, a manager. But he's got to be a Libra. But you see, in dealing with me, the relatives didn't know that they were dealing with a staunch character. And I tell you, if there's anything worse than a staunch woman, S-T-A-U-N-C-H. Nothing worse, I'm telling you. They don't weaken, no matter what. But they didn't know that. How would they know? So I can see now why girls get married. You know, they're forced into it. Oh, hello, Jerry, darling. Do you want to come in?
Going to the bathroom, right in back of my quarters.
Oh, isn't that awful?
No, I'm glad he is. I'm glad somebody's doing something he wants to
do.
Oh, yeah.
Can't get married to Sagittarius. They are very compatible so far as physical love goes, but there is little else that could be considered in a union here.
You see, that's what is so often forgotten. Pride. Nobody takes that into account. We're gonna have all that awful gang. Billy Jerry Lowe is Marjorie. Listen, I feel fine.
Great.
But everything is in a hell of a mess. My mother was yelling for something. Her little bag of ribbons. You saw Jerry just put the drawer right on the floor. So everything rolled around. So I had to wash all the silver and find all the little stuff.
Everything's in the attic. Everything from sloths, otters, badgers, possums, raccoons. Otters, badgers, sloths, possums.
It's all a question of who you want to stay with. Of course, I'm mad about animals, but raccoons and cats become a little bit boring. I mean, for too long a time.
Because the people that I wanted to marry, really, were Sagittarians. And they say, above all, don't marry Sagittarians. So I think they've got it all wrong. I don't know.
The fight for the East Hampton Village has begun, between the forces of good and the forces of evil. And I needn't tell you who the forces of evil are. Who's the party of special interest that all grinds down the little people? Who's the party that doesn't give a damn as long as they make millions to put in their bank? Who's the party that rounges around to find out all the dirt they can and use it against the opponent to destroy the two-party system that made America what it is today? Who's the party who delivered a crooked president?
The intense irony of the bursting of The hemorrhaging of the liver blows out.
Isn't that awful? You know, because I went back to the Catholic Church, I shouldn't be talking about astrology. I never had a split personality. I have a hell of a temper. It's sudden. You know what they said? That I was schizophrenic. No beagles. Schizophrenic.
It's very difficult to keep the line between the past and the present. You know what I mean?
Meow.
Oh.
You're wasting that thing on this, and that's nuts.
She's a lot of fun. I hope she does in the demo.
So what is the actual date that it goes down in history that the Maisels began the film with the Beatles? It was September...
The 7th of September.
Yeah. We have to look into
I'll take
that.
This. This
See
is
what
thinning.
That means. What is
this
that?
Is thinning.
Oh, yeah. Right.
I'll take cottage cheese.
Don't eat. Just give me the cheese whiz. Please don't take anything out. We don't want anything but the cheese whiz.
Here's a toast to the Grey Gardens.
Oh, merci beaucoup.
Now, darling, you and your brother are so crazy about both of you. You'll never know.
Well, don't get them too crazy now, don't.
No, but they try to bring back the spirit that was crushed out of us.
I never had anything crushed out of me.
My God, they... I don't know what they did to me, the relatives and the natives and the...
Well, of course, Edie, you must remember.
Mixed young clubbers and all the horrible...
She's a southern girl. She's very upset about the raids, you know, the raids.
Raids are really... Detective force.
Edie, you must watch your face, baby. You're spoiling your face, making those terrible noises and sounds. You must always make a beautiful picture. No, I have to be perfect for the singing.
Okay.
You have to give me a little time to sing. I think I still have a bad cold, don't you? Who do you think I have?
16, we appreciate the demands of a professional.
Mm-hmm, yes, and I'm going to make it
right,
the best.
That's right. It has to be right.
I want to be the best. I wanted to be at least as good as I was when I sang for Mr. Narcissus. I got this whole contract on 3 songs. I sang over the air, you know, for Mr. Narcissus. And
one contract.
The big contract. The big contract.
Oh, the big contract.
What's that?
So then he sang to me. I don't know what he wanted out of me, but I
have the house done or something.
I don't know what he wanted out of me, but he sang 3 songs anyway, and I sang the first song, Toujours l'amour. I sang the songs that Jacqueline asked me to sing. She remembered them as when I was a little child. I used to sing them, and she remembered Iris and. Toujours l'amour, and I dream too much, Lily Pons. Edie knows that very well. And Edie has a voice just like Lily Pons. Would you believe that girl has a gorgeous voice? That woman there?
Yeah.
No, she has one of the most beautiful.
Am I crazy, but is my memory correct or not? But that Edie maybe even looks a little like Lily Pons.
Yeah, oh, she does. You're absolutely correct.
I
tell you, oh yes, you are very true about that. She's very French looking, Edie is very French. And Lily Pons was supposed to have the highest palate in France, and Edie's was supposed to have the highest palate in America. You know, just a 38.
They tell me that all these dentists.
Yeah, said you ought to sing like Lily Pons. You have the highest palate.
So they couldn't get over it. Every time they looked at it, they almost died.
Oh yeah, they told Mr. Beale about it. He said, "Be sure that girl sings because she has magnificent throat and palate for singing."
Would you say that Edie is very palatable?
Very palatable. Isn't yes, I ate one big toe the other day, but it wasn't too
hot. Isn't he something?
And she's had a big sore toe for a long time. How is that toe, Edie?
Oh, my feet are passing out. I don't know.
Well, you may have diabetes. The first sign, you know, when your feet hurt you, and you wash them and bathe them, and you eat correct and everything, you're still passing out. You have diabetes.
All right, I'll take this.
Remember when you told Lois she's going to die? You may die before she does.
I saw death out in the garden.
Well, the birds are dying out there.
I screamed when I saw it.
Well, don't predict anything bad.
I went out to find the perk.
You know what? Oh, my God! Is it after 6?
Oh, my God. 6:15?
Is it?
Yeah.
Oh, no.
It's 8:30.
It's 8:30.
Oh, Dr. Norman Vincent Peale cannot be heard Sunday.
I am so in love with him.
But what is it? It's every Sunday?
At 6:15.
At 6:15.
He's very good.
How about toujours l'amour, Edie? Oh, l'amour, toujours l'amour. At last I found you, only unfold me always, thrill me and fill all my days, and wave your spell around me, l'amour to you, l'amour, sing to me love's old, old story.
Glory,
l'amour to you. Sing that along.
We could do a duet. I could sing the first alto.
How's the beginning of that toujours l'amour go, Edie? How's the beginning go, Edie?
I don't know.
Oh, yes, you do. You know it as well as you know the chorus. Certainly do. Oh, yes.
Ed, 275 on 127.
Oh, yes, I found you.
Oh, oh love, I found you at last.
Oh, love,
in my heart is a song.
I have dreamed of love in the past. I have waited for you so long,
so long,
so long, everlasting. And now all my dreams have come true.
L'amour toujours, l'amour.
Love now at last I've found you. Hold me and fold me always. Love me and thrill all my days. And weave your spell around me. Weave your spell
toujours l'amour, toujours.
Sing to me love's old glory.
Yearning a glory, l'amour toujours.
The beginning of that's pretty in the chorus, don't you think so?
You know something? I'm getting to Canción de Buenos Aires very quickly. I'm getting it now.
Let's sing Iris for a rep. I haven't any voice, but I'll sing Iris. Can I sing Iris?
Where's the major? Where's the major?
Iris. You know, it's a flower.
This is Mother's favorite.
No, I can't. Iris, no voice terrific. Today. I have to talk all my songs.
Okay, that's okay.
I have no voice at all.
Sounds good.
No, I don't think
the
so.
Content, anyway.
Well, I don't know. The words are pretty. I love all the words.
Want to do a soft shoe and the cane?
Is that a... Yeah.
Do you want the cane?
Isn't David terrific? Is that a cat? I heard a squeak then. Did you?
Did you hear
a squeak?
A new cat?
There he is. It's where? Whiskers. He's
oh,
here for
no,
his dinner.
Don't tell me
Hello,
he's
Whiskers.
Home. Is he home?
Whiskers.
Oh, he's hungry.
Come on, Whiskers.
Can you let him in, babe?
Yeah. Come on, Whiskers.
Get some food. Get that pie. Leave it here.
I'll get it.
My voice got him. He knew my voice.
I worship at your feet, inhaling your sweet perfume. Iris, your incense maddens me. See, now I swoon. Iris, your purple touched with gold. nature's flaming theme.
Whiskers.
Iris.
Whiskers.
Iris, I adore you. Now I die.
I get him.
But I breathe your name.
That's pretty small. Aren't the words lovely?
Yeah.
Got the words.
Whiskers came back.
And Whiskers?
He can't get Whiskers through that screen. There's a screen in the hall. He can't get through.
Come on, I got the palm.
He smells, he smells my voice or wants to eat the pie. He smells my voice or wants to eat the pie.
This is what drove East Hampton crazy. It was one vine that hung that way for 3 years. And they used to come in and say, but that vine was that way last summer. And I'd say, yeah, I know it was. And finally they'd come in and say, but it was that way 4 years ago. And I'd say, yeah, it was. You know, you're supposed to get a new husband every year, new wife every year, new vine every year, new pair of shoes every year. David, you look terrific today.
Everybody would want to see how the Beatles lived and if they're crazy.
No,
so they'll all go.
They'll all be going. Everyone will be
they'll
going.
All go to see if we're as nutty as we were made out.
Cleaned up much all day. We did a little bit.
Lois knows the house is only partially finished.
Would do. You got to dig up those pieces of wood out
well,
there and put in new
wood. That is going. It's where to put everything.
Oh, no. You got to fix the floors, Edie.
Well, I know that, but it's where to put all your china and glass.
Oh,
I'm
not worried. It's
stuff.
All been stolen. I'm not worried about that.
I don't know what to do with it, God.
It's gone.
Sleeping on top of it, Brad.
You think these cats would be curious to know what's going on? So,
oh, they
those
know.
Two, Hippie is very relaxed.
And
the little one doesn't know enough not to be.
And Edie won't bring the brilliant ones in, and Whiskers is out caught
Whiskers
in the garden.
Whiskers left because he didn't care for what was
no,
taking place.
No, he went
the
down the tree, Lois.
He
was so, they don't like to stay in. He's a coon cat.
He didn't care for
and
Jerry
he fights,
Lois.
You know, with the other animals outside. He doesn't like it in here.
What happened when the raccoons were in here?
When the raccoons, they didn't come in this room, babe.
Well, they used to knock on the door all night long.
They scratched.
They want to have perpetual feeding.
You know,
Buster and his family, they wanted perpetual feeding all night long. Remember Buster, Mother?
Yeah.
Coming in all night
long.
He
still gets it pretty well.
No matter what you fed him, in the half an hour, Buster would be back. Bang, bang, bang.
I thought he was some relation to you.
Rid of the mafia.
He wants perpetual feeding. He must be Edie's first cousin.
Lois remembers it.
Oh, that was terrible.
It was a gang.
Vicious.
Correct.
We're having Jerry fix up those holes. They went right through the wall, did you see? My brand
new
wall.
That's where I put Lois's profit. I was
going
to hang it on the other side. Now I'm going to hang it up there instead. I wanted to sell them, Lois.
You can get $30 a piece for those baby raccoons. We got six up in the attic. I'm crazy to sell them. You know, people want them. Everybody wants a raccoon nowadays. The most tame, lovely animal in the world. Way ahead of cats, yeah. Nobody wants a cat now. Nobody wants a cat. Oh, they're adorable. I love the crazy mad.
You don't have any in here.
They're up in the attic.
They went wild again.
You like them so much.
Oh, well, you can't mix them with the cats.
The cats don't
like them. No, they'd eat the cats.
No, the cats don't like the raccoons. They chase them.
Oh, well, darling, I do like them. I buy $2 worth of food for them every day.
The raccoons?
Yes, raccoons.
And I've got cats
day.
Beating Lois, dear, but nobody knows it.
Well, they're brilliant.
Well, I think children like the little ones.
Have you ever seen the little baby ones?
Have you ever seen the
little baby ones like that?
You evidently, well, what do you do?
What do they do?
You keep them as pets because of the cats.
Oh, you can train them. You can train them. People buy them.
I'm not going to take them to the homes.
Jerry told me he'd do two days' work if I gave him a raccoon. I'll do
really?
2 days' work for you for nothing.
I don't want Jerry up there.
Because
why
he,
didn't you give him a raccoon?
Because
I want
he's
to,
be
and he won't let me.
And his mother
not going to be injured
so at all.
That's Edie's negative mind. He's not going to be.
Raccoon and we'll lose the house.
Lois, they sell them everywhere, babe. Some people get 60.
Lois, darling, I'm safe, darling. This is Beale's house. The raccoon will injure the boy.
Oh, no.
The father raccoon.
Oh, no.
Don't
you believe it? There's a way of getting them. They got all my cats, Lois.
I can't do it anymore. I'm not insured.
They got lassoed all my cats
out there. I'm not insured. I'm not going to have Jerry go up there and have his fingers taken off.
That's the way Edie lives.
Like
but no faith at all. Oh, they're wonderful.
No, Lois, dear, the animal.
Wonderful, people. Wonderful.
I have very good fathers and mothers. Wonderful. They're not like human
Maybe
beings.
Have one for
the father and mother of Buster are going to kill when Jerry comes
out. That is
up.
Not so. That's your negative mind. There's no truth in that. One
human
iota.
Beings don't care.
No iota. They sold every day. They sell hundreds and hundreds of those. Raccoons every day, they're in vogue, you know.
I thought they just sold the raccoons for the cults originally.
Oh, Lord, you couldn't kill them.
She means baby.
No, that
she doesn't
they don't do that anymore.
Baby. Oh, I know, you know,
they sell them for pets now.
The old ones are very good.
And you can't put your finger out and say, would you like to have a piece of bread? You have to throw it to them, but afterwards they might get tame enough not to eat your finger.
I'm talking about the mothers and fathers.
I don't think I've been.
Yoo-hoo, she doesn't get it, Lois, darling. She wants little Jerry to have his little raccoon.
No, the girl asked me, Cheryl.
Bite his whole hand off.
Cheryl asked me for one. That's a girl.
I don't care how many ask you for one. We'll have but a lawsuit when they're injured.
But you want them here?
Edie,
that's the way Edie lives.
You've certainly never been harmed by one of them.
No, well, a little bit in the
not
heel.
Not much. Hang on, bit me.
No, only the father and mother.
Yeah,
not
well,
the
that's
babies.
What I'm talking about, the fathers
not
and
the
mothers.
Babies.
Who'd you think I was talking about, the babies?
Edie, you sound very unattractive.
Yeah,
Lois. You know, do you think Edie could go on the stage? I don't know.
She doesn't get it, Lois.
Do you think she could go on the stage? Because she loses her temper so badly.
Poor mother.
That's not temper, but
no control. No control. Terrible. Our grandmother was always preaching up control.
Maybe Lois would like one. Little baby raccoon. Would you like one?
Yes.
After you tell me about biting the hand off and everything.
Well, that's when you try to catch it.
You know, my father had a coat like that once, Lois.
Oh, I see. They're really wild then.
Oh, yes, they're wild. But you tame them. You take them to your house and tame them. You bring them up like a little kitten or a little puppy.
I see.
They're adorable, Lois.
The nearest thing to a child.